Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to use the Microsoft Visio Data Visualizer within Microsoft Excel in order to create a process diagram that is compatible with Microsoft Visio. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So first, I'm going to go down here to my taskbar and type Excel in the search bar and start up Microsoft Excel. Once I'm in there, I'm going to select blank workbook. In order to use the Microsoft Visio Data Visualizer, you will need to install it as an add-in within Microsoft Excel. You can do that by going to the Insert menu and going over here to this button that says Get Add-ins. And once you're in the add-ins, just go here up to the search box and type in Visio and hit search. And over here, you will see Microsoft Visio Data Visualizer. Just click the Add button from here, and it will be installed in your version of Excel. I already have this installed on my computer, so I'm going to X out of here and go over here to My Add-ins and use the drop-down here and just select Microsoft Visio Data Visualizer. And once the add-in loads, I can see that I'm not able to view all of the information in the add-in. So I'm going to hover over this right corner right here with my mouse until I get this double-headed arrow. And then I'm going to click my left mouse button and just drag up a tiny bit. And that will allow me to access this link down here that says Continue Without Signing In. Once I click on that, the data visualizer will bring me to a bunch of different kinds of flowcharts that I can use that are integrated within Microsoft Excel. So these flowcharts not only create the diagram, but they also create the underlying data that is necessary to create the diagram in the first place. So if I want to do a simple process flowchart, I can look here and I can see that I have a few different templates for what I can use. I can use a horizontal one, I can use a vertical one, I can also have one with different hierarchies. So for the purpose of our lesson today, let's just click on this vertical one right here. And I'm going to scroll down and click Create. So right now I can see that a process flow diagram has been created for me. But where is this data coming from? If you look over here to the right, and I'm going to scroll over to the right in Excel, I can see that this table has been created automatically by the data visualizer. And this table is where my information is coming from. So I can see my process step IDs, I can see a description, I can tell what the next step is, and this field is very important. And I can also have a connector label such as yes or no, and I can denote what my shape type should be right there. So let's look at some of this a little bit more in detail. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. These are the steps of my process. It should be create, module, publish, address, end. And if I look over here, I can see create, module, address, publish, and end. So these labels on each of these shapes is coming from this column right here, the second column, column W. The order for my headings over here in my diagram is different than the order for them right here. And let me tell you why. Because if I go over here to next step ID, see the P200? That means that after create course module, the next step to happen is P200. And what is P200? Well, if I look back here at the process step ID, I can see that P200 is module passes review with a question mark. And so when I look over here, I can see that create has module passes review, that step right after. But then if I look here, I can see that I have two step IDs following module passes review. And I have that because one is a yes and one is a no. So if I go over here, I can see both step 300 is down here and step 400 is right here. And also, if I look at step 400, I can see that the next step is 300, which is published course. That's why these are out of order, because 400 is supposed to come before 300. And the data visualizer knew that intuitively, and that's why it put these steps in that order. And then finally, after step 300, I can see my next step is P500, and P500 is right here with this end. So before we go over the connector label, let's go over the shape type. If I click in this column right here, I can see that my shape type is actually a drop-down box. So let's see what some of our options are there. I can have a start and an end, and you can see that in my flowchart, the start and the end shapes are over here. They are this oval type shape with the first and the last steps in my flowchart. And remember when we talked about step P200, where it had two possible options? Well, right here, that was selected as a decision. And usually inside of a flowchart, a decision is denoted with a diamond type shape. And that's because on one side of the diamond, you're going to get what happens if I say yes and what happens if I say no. So in this case, with this decision, if I say yes, I'm going to go down here to this step, which is step P300. And if I say no, I'm going to go down to this step right here that is P400. So the connector label over here is yes and no. And you can see that in the diagram that right here is yes and right here is no. They just labeled it that way, and you would want to label that because otherwise the person reading your flowchart is not going to know which path this is and which path this is. So next we have a shape type of process, which is denoted by a square over here. And then the address the feedback is a subprocess that looks similar over here to a process, but it has these lines in it so that you can look at that and see that that is a subprocess. And here it makes sense because you have to address your feedback before you're going to publish your course. So you want to make sure that that subprocess is taken care of. And you will do that subprocess in the event that your module has not passed review. And then once you've published your course, you can go to the end, which again is that oval type shape down here. Now, these shape types are associated already within the Microsoft Visual Data Visualizer. If you're using Visio itself, you can have more flexibility as to what those shapes are going to be and what that relationship is going to be. And we will go over how to create a process diagram in our next tutorial that we will release later on this week. But I wanted to just show you a quick way to make a very fast process flow diagram within Microsoft Excel using the Microsoft Visio Data Visualizer. I would like to show you one more quick thing before the end of this video. If I go over here and I select this row and I right click and go to insert and go to table rows above, I can put another step in here that says maybe P150, and I can just write new step. And if I say my next step ID is P200, and I can make that, let's just say, another process. And then I click over here and go to refresh. You can see that I can add another step inside of my process by just adding it to the table over here. If I go up to next step ID and I make this one P150, it'll be a little more linear and probably what I'm trying to do. So you can edit all of the information over here, go to refresh, and have your process flowchart reflect those changes that you have made in this Excel table over here. So hopefully you've learned something new today. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. As always, thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.